My name is Monica, and I'm a science educator. Join me as we take a close look at research expeditions to track blue whales and better understand this incredible ocean species. Ever try to call a friend from across the room? What if they're on the other side of a busy playground? Now, imagine if you were trying to call them from miles and miles away, and underwater. That's exactly what blue whales do when they communicate over hundreds of miles of open ocean.
Oceanographer Dr. Kate Stafford is listening in to understand what they're trying to say.
Pretty amazing!
I spent a lot of time thinking about blue whales and blue whale calls. Like, the number one thing I want to know for sure is, what's it for? What does it mean to them?
Her team uses hydrophones to listen to whale songs far beneath the surface of the ocean. They're microphones, but specially designed to record underwater. And they're very sensitive. They can pick up sounds from really, really far away. The hydrophone might record animal calls that are high and squeaky, like this. Animals like dolphins communicate with these types of sounds. Take a listen. We might also hear low sounds
that are deep and rumbly.
That's how many whales call to each other.
This highness or lowness of a sound, it's called its pitch. Give it a try. What's the lowest noise you can make? What about the highest?
Large whales tend to make sounds that are quite low and rumbly. And blue whales make some of the lowest pitched sounds in the world. In fact, we can't hear most sounds the blue whales make.
Humans need to use hydrophones and computers to study them.
The first step is recording the calls.
When we get our data back or when we're in the field, we can make a display of the sound, basically a picture of the sound. And we actually look at the sounds more than we listen to them.
That's right. A picture of the sound. Every call has its own shape. And when they try to match the calls to the whale's behavior, they can understand what each call means. This call is used to find a potential mate. And this call is used to say, "Hey, I found food. Come quick." Can you hear and see the difference? With all the sound that the hydrophones pick up, it can sometimes be hard to sort out what's what. And it's not just animal sounds that cause a ruckus. Ships and other ocean machines make a lot of noise down there too. And a lot of it is at the same low pitch that whales use. That can make it hard for whales to hear each other, and hard for Kate to hear the whales too. We call these background sounds noise pollution. Just like air pollution, noise pollution can be bad for us and for all other creatures we share our planet with.
If you can imagine maybe being in a really crowded school when everybody's making a ton of noise, you can talk to the person across the table from you, but you might not be able to hear a conversation four or five tables over. And then, say a big school bus drives by, that makes it even louder and it makes it even harder for you to hear important information. And the same is true for blue whales and any marine species because they need sound to survive.
And it's not just marine species that rely on sound.
If you go outside and listen carefully and try to block all other distracting noise, you'll start to hear all kinds of animals that communicate using sound. The sounds of nature are all around us. And if you spend enough time watching and listening, maybe you'll even be able to figure out what they're trying to say. Just like Kate does with the whales.
If you are interested in getting into wildlife, studying whales, studying anything, start in your own backyard. Start observing nature. Observe the bees in your garden. Observe the ants you see on the sidewalk, and you'll start seeing patterns.
That's a lot easier than getting a blue whale to give me a call. I think I'll try it. I think she just tweeted me.